Yes, dear student, in the previous video we have covered the part about the polymer, classification of polymer, three types of polymer, classification of polymer we have on the basis of monomer, on the basis of structure and on the basis of thermal behavior. Okay, in this video we are going to cover the types of, first we are going to see the polymerization, then types of polymerization and few examples of polymers. Okay, so let us proceed further. So first we will see what is the polymerization. Polymerization, it is nothing but the process of formation of polymer. Simply, we are going to call what is that polymerization. Polymerization, it is a process. It is process of what? It is the process of formation of polymer. So the process of formation of polymer, it is called the polymerization. Okay, this is the simple definition, but in a scientific way, polymerization, how polymers are formed, they are formed by the joining the monomers. Okay, so either this monomer is similar or different types of monomers. Okay, so we are going to see in detail. It is the process of linking large number of smaller and simple molecules of similar or different types. Okay, means what? Monomers. See, monomer means what? They are the small and simple molecules of similar or different types under the condition of temperature, pressure and catalyst forming a large molecule. Large molecule, that large molecule we are going to call as a polymer, with or without elimination of any other product like water, NaCl, HCl. This is the scientific definition of polymerization. Okay, so polymerization, it is nothing but the formation of polymer, process of formation of polymer, it is called the polymerization. Okay, so polymerization, polymers are formed, and polymers are formed from the monomers. And what is monomer? Monomer, it is small and simple molecules, large number of small, and suppose here I am going to write this is the M. M is the monomer. I am taking the N number of that monomer. When they are linking to each other, this M, it is connected to other monomer, this it is connected to other monomer. See, in the beginning it is a small and simple, but when they are going to join, we are taking the N number of monomers, when they are going to link with each other, long chain polymer is formed. Okay, that long chain, in the beginning initially its weight is less, but when they are going to form the long chain, its molecular weight is also increased. Okay, so one of the important condition, when monomers undergo repeated addition under the condition of temperature, pressure and catalyst, it is called the polymerization. Okay, so this is the definition of polymerization. After that we are going to see the types of polymerization. There are the two types of polymerization. One is addition polymerization and another is the condensation polymerization. Okay, first we are going to start the addition polymerization. What is that addition polymerization? Name itself indicate, only there is a addition is taking place, nothing is eliminated out. Okay, so addition polymerization, simply remember, without elimination of any product like water, HCl, only repeated addition is there, that time we are going to call it as a addition polymerization. Okay, and another type, that is the condensation polymerization. Here in condensation polymerization, two different monomers are present. Okay, condensation means they are going to condense, and when they are going to condense, that time simple products, here there is a elimination of product like water, HCl, they are eliminated. Okay, and here in addition polymerization, which type of polymer is that formed? It is the homopolymer is formed, because all the monomers are similar here. Here in condensation, copolymer is formed, because two different types of monomers are present, so it is going to form the copolymer. Okay, so two types of addition polymerization and condensation polymerization, that we are going to see in the detail. First we are going to start the addition polymerization. So what is that addition polymerization? Here it is the process in which monomers undergo repeated addition. Okay, remember this word, repeated addition, only there is a addition. Okay, when they are going to repeatedly add, there is a formation of long chain polymer. And this is the important condition, that is without elimination of any molecule. None of the molecules is eliminated or any byproduct is formed here. Okay, so addition polymerization, only there is a addition is there, nothing is eliminated out. okay. So only monomer with C double bond C is present in this type of polymerization. No byproducts are obtained. Okay, here no byproducts are obtained. Only C double bond C is present in this type of polymerization, and the polymer which is formed, it is having the linear structure. Okay, so all this is about the addition. Remember, only addition means repeatedly added to form the long chain polymer without elimination. Nothing is eliminated out. Okay, that type of polymerization we are going to call it as a addition polymerization. Okay, so first example of addition polymerization that we are going to see here, it is the formation of polyethylene. Though it is polyethylene, you are calling it as a polythene bags, carry back, you are seeing that polyethylene, actually it is the polyethylene. Okay, so here polyethylene, name itself indicate poly, this is means poly means many. Which monomer is used here? Ethylene. Okay, see here the structure of ethylene, already I said to you in my previous lecture also, this is the structure of ethylene. Here everywhere hydrogen is present, okay, double bond is present. Unsaturation is necessary in monomer. Unsaturation must be the present. If it is a saturated, you can't use it as a monomer. Okay, so in the formation of polyethylene, ethylene molecule takes part. See here, ethylene C double bond C, here everywhere hydrogen is present. So when it undergoes the repeated addition, see here we have written n means the, we have taken the n number of molecules of that ethylene. Okay, when it undergoes the repeated addition, that time long chain polymer is formed. Okay, long chain polymer is formed, that we are going to call it as a polyethylene. Okay, see here, this is the one ethylene molecule, this is another. So what is happening here? Double bond is open actually. Okay, double bond is open, so one radical is free here. One of the electron, one here and one here, free radical is formed. Another same free radical is formed, and these free radical, they are going to join together, and there is a formation of chain. When two are present, two ethylene, then it is dimer, trimer, tetramer, continuously there is addition. So that's why it is called the polyethylene. Okay, you can see it here. Here one ethylene molecule is here, the double bond, here it is continue, so another, so continuously added. And here it is a very large molecule, long, n is the very large integer, n number, n, it is also called the degree of polymerization. Degree of polymerization, it may be the 100, sometime it is the 1000 number of molecules, sometime it is a 10,000, even in lakhs are also present. Okay, that is called the degree of polymerization. So here this is about the polyethylene. Tell me, in polyethylene only one monomer is repeatedly added, means identical, similar monomers are added. That's why this polyethylene, it is going to form which type of polymer? It is going to form the homopolymer. Homopolymer means all the monomers are identical. That's why this is the homopolymer. And see here, linear structure, you can see here, linear chain is formed only. Okay, so it is, its structure is linear chain structure. Okay, polyethylene having the linear chain structure. Polyethylene, saglyani bagitlela ahe polythene. Polythene kasa asto? Soft asto. Soft asto, heat kela tar te soft hoto. Carry katana, and less brittle asto. Less brittle manje te futat nahi. Okay, so this is the formation of polyethylene. Next we are going to see the condensation polymerization. What is condensation polymerization? It is the process in which, see here, different monomers, in addition it is the similar, same monomers are repeatedly added, but in condensation polymer, different monomers join together forming a large polymer with elimination of simple molecule like water, HCl, etc. Okay, see here, different monomers are present in this type of polymerization. Byproducts are obtained like water, HCl are obtained. It form the polymer with the cross-linked structure. Okay, now you can tell me here, two different types of monomers are present, means which type of polymer is formed here? Here copolymer is formed. As different monomers are present, so it is going to form by a condensation polymerization copolymer is formed. Okay, example of condensation polymerization, in that we are going to see the formation of nylon 6,6. Okay, why it is called 6,6, I will explain you later. See how it is obtained. It is obtained by the condensation polymerization of hexamethylene diamine, hexamethylene. See here, this is the methylene. How many? 6. Hexa means 6. Hexamethylene diamine. Diamine means here is, this is amine group. Di means 2. One to this side and another to this side. This is the hexamethylene diamine. And here is the adipic acid. Adipic acid, this is the structure of adipic acid. Okay, this is the structure of adipic acid. See here, how many carbons are present here? In this structure, 6 carbons are present. Here, 4, 5, 6. Here also 6 carbons are present. So that's why this nylon is called nylon 6,6. In hexamethylene diamine, 6 carbons are present. And in adipic acid, this is the formula of adipic acid, 6 carbons are present. That's why it is called the nylon 6,6. Okay, how it is formed? Here see, two different monomer. One is hexamethylene diamine and another is adipic acid. Here two different monomers are there. That's why we are going to call it as a copolymer. By condensation polymerization, copolymer is formed. Okay, see here, this is the hexamethylene diamine, CH2 6, NH2 amine group, n number of we have taken. Here it is the adipic acid, CH2 COOH. This is the structure of adipic acid. It undergoes the condensation polymerization. That time water molecule is eliminated. Okay, shortly I am going to elaborate this one. This is the hexamethylene. So I am going to split this hydrogen as a, here is a 1 and here is a 1. Two hydrogens are here. I have written one here and another is here. Similarly, I am going to write like this. Okay, so next, plus adipic acid. Adipic acid, this is the structure of adipic acid. I have separately written this structure. Okay, next, CH2. Here it is the 4. C double bond O and OH. Now see, in condensation polymerization, what is happening? This H from the amine and OH from that adipic acid, they are going to condense together. They are going to condense and water molecule is eliminated from here. Here H from this and OH from this. So two water molecules are eliminated when one molecule of hexamethylene and one molecule of adipic acid is joining. So 2NH2O is eliminated here. And this is the structure. See here. So when it is eliminated, so NH, CH26, NH, here they are going to join. This is CO, CH24, CO, N after polymerization. And remember one thing. Okay. If in polymerization reaction, to the left side, in the beginning you have to write DN, and after polymerization what you have to write, in the square bracket you have to write the C, and at the subscript you have to write N like this. So this is your polymer. It is showing that it is a polymer. Here you have to take in the beginning N number of molecules, and after polymerization you have to show here at the subscript. Okay, so here it is, the polymer is formed. That name is the nylon 6,6. Why it is 6? Because hexamethylene 6 carbon is present, and in adipic acid 6 carbon. So that's why it is called the nylon 6,6 with elimination of 2 water molecule. Okay, 2N, because we are taking the N number. So here it is, a 2N water molecules are eliminated in this. Okay, next we are going to see the difference between these fastly. Here monomers only. Which type of polymer it is going to form? It is going to form the homopolymer. This is the copolymer. Next, no byproducts are obtained. Here byproducts are obtained. Here number of monomeric units decreases steadily throughout the reaction. Monomers disappear at the early stage of the reaction. Okay, here molecular weight is less, here molecular weight is high. Okay, next, here they are going to form the thermoplastic, and they are going to form the thermosetting plastic. Okay, here homopolymer, here heterochain polymer, or it is also called the copolymer. This is about the types of polymerization. Thank you.